Hello students, welcome back to our EVS class. This is the summary of chapter number 2, Our Senses. Children, first of all let us recall your preschool rhyme, Five Senses. Five senses, five senses. We have them, we have them. Seeing, hearing, touching, tasting and smelling. There are five, there are five. Sense organs. Sense organs are the external organs of our body. Organs such as eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin help us to see, hear, smell, taste and touch. Our sense organs help us to receive information about the world around us. They sense things and send signal to the brain. The brain gives instructions according to which our body reacts. We can see with our eyes, hear with our ears, smell with our nose, taste food with our tongue, and feel with our skin. Now let us discuss the functions of the sense organs. First we have eye. Eyes help us to read books, watch television and see things around us with the help of our eyes. The nerves of eyes send signals to our brain. The brain instructs the body accordingly. Next, let us discuss the functions of nose. Our nose helps us to smell various types of odors. The smell of flowers and perfumes is pleasant, while the smell from garbage is unpleasant. Next, we have ear. We can hear various types of sound with the help of our ears. We can hear the sound of a bell, horn of cars, barking of dogs, etc. Next we have tongue. We can taste various types of food items with the help of our tongue. Thousands of taste buds are found on our tongue. Skin. We can feel various types of touches with the help of our skin. A touch can be soft, hard, smooth, rough, wet, dry, sticky, slippery, etc. Next, let us discuss about tongue. The tongue is a sense organ. It helps us to taste different things. The tongue has a large number of taste buds on it. Taste buds on the tongue are of four types. They can sense the sweet, salty, sour, and bitter taste. The location of these taste buds has been shown in the picture below. Functions of tongue. Our tongue helps us to speak. Tongue helps to mix the saliva with the food. It also helps us to swallow the food. Children, there is one activity in your textbook. You have to complete it. Close your eyes. Think which are the activities you can do easily and the ones you cannot do. Complete the table below. Activities I can do. Activities I cannot do. First, let us see activities I can do. I can sleep. Next, activities I cannot do. I cannot read books. I can breathe. I cannot watch television. I can listen music. I cannot write properly. I can smell. I cannot draw properly. Children, please write it in your EVS textbook. Next, let us discuss about differently abled people. Many people are unable to use a particular part of their body. Such people are called physically disabled people or differently abled people. Next, let us discuss about lame. A person who has difficulty walking due to an injured leg or foot is called lame. Who is lame? A person who has difficulty in walking due to an injured leg or foot is called lame. Children, we should respect their disability and help them by giving them a seat in the public transport, by helping them to climb the stairs, by slowly pushing their wheelchair if required. Children, these are the walking aids used by the people who are unable to walk. Next, let us see who is dumb. People who cannot speak are called dumb. Children, who is dumb? People who cannot speak are called dumb. A dumb person expresses his or her thoughts and feelings using a special language called sign language. We should not make fun of them or the sign language used by them. Children, look at the screen. This is sign language. Next, let us see who is blind. Blind people are the people who cannot see at all. We should not make fun of blind people. We should help them in every possible way, such as helping them to cross the road by reading a book aloud to them. There are many such people who have inspired all of us. For example, Beethoven, Helen Keller, and Sudha Chandran. Next, let us discuss about good and bad touch. The skin gives us the sense of touch. Some touches, such as hugging parents, grandparents or friends, holding hands of a friend, etc., give us a good and comfortable feeling. These touches are called good touches. Children, what is good touch? Some touches, such as hugging parents, grandparents or friends, holding hands of a friend, etc., give us a good and comfortable feeling. These touches are called good touches. Sometimes we feel uncomfortable when anyone touches us. We are scared, confused, and hurt too. These uncomfortable touches are called bad touches. We should be able to differentiate the good touch from the bad touch. We should stay away from people who make us feel uncomfortable. There are some things in our house which we are not allowed to touch. Make a list of these things. First, sharp knives. Next, lighters and matches. Hot utensils. Scissors. Electric switches. Blade. Children, these are some things in our house which we are not allowed to touch. Children, I have already sent question answers of this chapter. So please write down those question answers in your EVS notebook and watch the video also. Children, there will be class test next Friday. Thank you and have a nice day.